Hey guys, today we're going to go over how to install mods for 1.64 to, I think, 1.75? I think they should probably work with any versions up until the fact that they have a new launcher. However, we're going to be focusing specifically on Forge mods. I don't think Mod Loader is around anymore, but anyway, I digress. I will even also go over how to install Optifine with Forge. Let's begin. Now, first thing you need to do, I'm going to automatically assume you know a little bit about computers. You've already have your Java already all the way updated and you have the right bit version. However, I'm going to assume you don't know anything about installing Minecraft mods at all. So the first thing you need to do is you need to learn where Minecraft is going to install stuff. I'm going to assume that you're already played Minecraft once before. So you already have saves, you already have your worlds and all that stuff that you want to keep. Learning how to do a backup is very, very important because if you update your mods, you're going to have to do a world backup because sometimes things can get corrupted. So, okay. First thing you need to do is you need to locate your directory. How do you do this? You go to start and you go to this little search bar down here in your start menu. If you're running on an older version of Windows, you want to go to Run, which can also be accessed via Windows and R. Okay? Then you type in percentage sign app data, like that. You hit enter, and then you can go here. Now, obviously, you can see a bunch of these files. Don't mess with anything else but .minecraft. This is exactly where we're looking for. This is exactly where we're going. Okay, now you can see here, as I open the file, you have a bunch of logs, etc., etc. All this right here is, because I already have mods installed, but don't worry, I will back this up and use this for later because this might, you know, my little single player world. I'm going to take this and back this all up. So basically, select this all. I'm going to hit Control Copy. You could also right click it and hit Copy. And I'm going to go to another folder, which is Mod Backup here. Open up a new folder. Call it Backups. Head in and hit right click paste, or you could hit Control P. Whatever preference you have for this. It's gonna take me a while. Quite a few mods installed. Okay, so now that we have our map backup ready, you can send this to a zip file to conserve it in one space, and of course, as you can see, it makes things a whole lot smaller to zip these. However, you need a zip program for this. You can either use WinRAR and 7-zip. I currently am using 7-zip. It's up to you. But however, you're not going to need it for anything else in this tutorial, so don't worry about it. Okay, so now that we have our backups set away, all good, we need to make a clean install of Minecraft. Now, how do you do this? Make sure your launcher is somewhere on your desktop. Mine's right here. And you just select all of this and hit Shift Delete. And boosh, it goes away. Then you launch up your Minecraft. As you can see, stuff is filling in. This is for launcher details, versions, and of course, login. Oop. There we go. Misspell. All right, now that we got this all the way updated, I usually just say hit play first. And this will install the current version of Minecraft, which is 1.75? It'll go ahead and install that, but don't worry. I'm going to take us back to 1.64. However, if you want to stay on this version, go ahead. Just the next section is... You can pay attention to the next section because that's going to teach you how to set up a profile and how to go back a version if you want to. But otherwise, if you want to stay on 1.75, don't have to listen to this next section. There we go. So now we have 1.75. Go ahead and close this out. If you're following still. Whoop. Kinda. Here. Okay, so launcher again. Run your launcher again. Let it start up. Now we're gonna talk about setting up a profile. That's what this little box here. Don't mess with this, this is for your user. I think it automatically sets it up under user, your username, when you launch it for the first time. So this one is going to be the current one. Just keep that in mind. Okay, so we go to new one. We're going to call this one 1.64. Then you have game directory. That's where you change the installation of Minecraft. We'll be leaving that alone. Resolution. When the game starts up, what resolution does it go into? But since we can hit the maximize button, just leave it alone. I usually change this to keep launcher open, which is under launcher visibility. Development build, this is if you want to play with the beta, the snapshots. Beta craft versions or old alpha versions. Those are just old versions of Minecraft from back in the day. We're going to be using 1.64 and ignore these for right now. So go ahead and hit save profile and run Minecraft again. Now it's going to install everything yet again. I think it's only going to download the jar file, which is basically just the basic bare bones of Minecraft. Because we have all the assets and stuff like that. So I don't think we need to. But yes, you need to do this to install Forge for 1.64. You need to have everything running at least once. So we'll go ahead and go to the Forge forms here. Now they got that. Close it out. And of course, the launcher stayed open for us. Because it's all nice. Craft Forge. Downloads. Okay. Now you want to download your Forge. So basically what you do, since we're going for 1.64 latest, now, you have the changelog, the installer, the Java doc, source, and universal. You want the installer. Don't worry about anything else. Just the installer. And the reason is because we're going straight for that one. This is going to be our API. This is going to be the backbone of all of our mods. So you want the installer so that it will automatically install everything for us. We don't have to worry about it. Okay, so now I got that done. We're gonna go to the downloads folder, which is here. And where is my Forge? Here it is. So I got Forge already downloaded. So basically, now you have a nice jar here. So you wanna right click it, open with Java Platform SE binary. Here we go. And it's gonna go ahead and install Forge for us. All nice and simple and good. And it's going to even create us a profile specifically for Forge. And of course, those are all the mods that I will be installing. I'm not going to install all of them, but those are my mods that I use. Even something that doesn't belong there. Alright. Now, we want to start Java. Is it we want to start this up again? Get the launcher up again. And we're going to check to make sure Forge is working. So now we want to pick the Forge save here. Obviously play. And then we're going to go to edit profile. Now we're going to keep the launcher visibility on. whole time. We're gonna change this to forge 164. And I think that's it. I'm gonna save that for now. Save profile. Okay. Then we're gonna go ahead, make sure Forge is working and everything's fine, which means launching it again. And of course, as you can see now, we have Forge installed. Everything is all good. Now, I did not have Optifine downloaded, so I don't usually use Optifine. So we'll go ahead and download it. We're gonna go for standard, older versions. Now, when you're downloading a mod, the basic, most important thing you need to know is what Minecraft you're using. If I download 174 and I put it into a 164 installation, everything will break. It will not work at all. So you always want to make sure that you have the correct version. Now, usually that will mean it has 164 somewhere in its title. So as you can see here, it says download Optifine 164 HDD1. That is exactly what we're looking for. So, you're gonna download this. Okay, so now we got Optifine in here somewhere. Optifine right there. Okay, so now we installed the jar file. So we wanna go back to our Minecraft directory, which is right here. Remember, it's the .minecraft folder. And we go into here to mods. There should be no other folder like core mods or anything like that. Just go to the mods folder, and then what you do is you just simply take your Optifine, which is right here, and you drag it over. You drop it in. And then, of course, every time you install a mod, you need to run Minecraft. Now just remember, you don't have... Oh, one thing that you need to remember is that you don't have to close down the launcher if you're installing a mod. You have to close down Minecraft. This is the launcher. The other window that pops up is Minecraft. Minecraft has to be closed to change anything in the .minecraft folder. I think you can install resource packs and saves without closing down Minecraft, but I would suggest you doing it anyway, just to be on the safe side. So you always close it down and then launch it back up after each installation. So, and the reason is also to check to make sure that there is no bugs in compatibility. So now, as you can see, everything loaded up. Whoop. So mods, I have Optifine right there. So just remember, Forge, then Optifine. Okay? Forge, then Optifine. So now we have Optifine installed. Close this out. Now I'm going to install NEI. I think that's a basic one. Now, NEI has a mod that it's dependent on another mod, so it said it needs another mod to run, which is Code Chicken Core. Code Chicken Core and any of Chicken Bones mods need to have the core file. If it does not have it, they will not run. They will just break. So when installing it, you always install cores. You need to make sure that each mod has its dependencies. If it doesn't have its dependencies, it will not function. Your Minecraft will crash. It'll be horrible and frustrating. So make sure you read the installation instructions on the forum posts. And make sure that you have the right version for your version of Minecraft, and make sure that you have any dependencies. And of course, make sure the dependencies are the right version for the mod that you're down, the version of the mod you're downloading. I know it sounds confusing, but you'll eventually get it. Make sure you have the right versions for Minecraft. Make sure you have the right versions of your dependencies. You should be good. So now I'm going to install Chicken Code Core, which is the dependency here, and then I'm going to be installing NEI, the latest version, because I have two NEIs. So we'll pop those in there. I'm going to get rid of the other NEI so I don't get confused. And I'm going to then run Minecraft to test. And of course, it's going to download some dependencies, things to make sure, libraries to make sure that it's running properly. It has everything that it needs. And there we go. Everything's good. And I keep clicking on that button. And so now we have chicken code core installed and not enough items. Of course, no installed plugins. So basically, you don't have to install it if you can install two mods at once if you have a core and the mod. But for every mod, you need to run afterwards. So I'm going to go ahead and do that until I get something. We're going to go ahead and install thermal expansion. Oop. So that was basically what happens when you do not install a dependency. You basically, it says crystal core, you know, could not find the power crystal's core minimum version required is 1.7. It's like 1.17. So basically I just have to go back here and find it. It should be here. There it is. And slam your dependency in. Normally I usually start with the core mods. So that way I make sure I have them all installed at the beginning. So that way I don't have to worry about whether I have them or not. Unless I'm missing one. Okay, so now we need to talk about IDconflicts. This is a typical problem that you're gonna have to run into. Now, basically, you see here it says a list of IDconflicts have been written to the file idconflicts.txt in your Minecraft directory. So go ahead and close Minecraft when this happens. Go to your main directory. Here it is. And this is, you can see the idconflicts and open it up. Now, basically, it'll give you a list of all the conflicting IDs, what mods are conflicting, and ranges of IDs that you can put in. Basically, it's, for those of you who don't know what I mean by this, every item and object in Minecraft is listed under an ID. This is so the Minecraft knows what it is. So basically what we need to do is we need to change biome of plenty, flowers, foliage, willow, plants, moss, tree moss, mushrooms, and coral to new IDs. And of course it gives me three ranges from suggestions. So to change the IDs of biomes plenty, we go into your back into your .minecraft folder, go to configs, and look for biome of plenty. So it says right here IDs config. We open this up, move it away so that I can see both again. And then basically we're just going to be looking for this ID, so 2000. Okay. Usually I hit that way I can find it. So there we go. Flower ID. And then close this out. And then of course I have my range here, which is 2268. So we will start 2286. 2268, sorry. 2286. And then the next number is 1, which is right here. So 2269. Next ID that I need to change is 2006. Where are you? I thought I saw you here. Anyway, you can always use define if you can't find something. And then 229, right? 226. 2270. Usually I write them down here as I go so I can remember because I have horrible memory. Next number is 08. Willow ID. So 2271. Next is 2013. Plant ID, which will be now 2272. Next one is 15. 2273. It's very important that you do not use the same ID twice, because then you're basically giving yourself the same problem that you had before instead of solving it. So now we got 2274. That's why I make sure that I know which one I'm doing and make sure that I'm not overlapping IDs. 2272. Is it 2017? So 2275, and then 18, which is our last one, which is going to be 2276. Okay, so then you save it, close these down. No, don't need to save it. Go away. And then, of course, run your Minecraft. This should work. And there we go. So that is the basics of installing mods for Minecraft. This is also how to back up and change your versions. So basically everything's covered here. Well, not everything, but most everything. Without having a little bit of Java knowledge, I may cover the rest, the more advanced stuff, later in a later video. So I will talk to you later. Thanks for watching and happy gaming.